Hello, I'm Gavin Hoey, and in this tutorial I'm going to show you how you can create some flaming text, a little bit like you see on screen. At least that's where I hope we're going to end up. Now, you've probably seen this sort of thing before, used in magazines and advertising. It's used all over the place. It's not an original idea, but I'm going to show you how you can create it in just a few minutes. Right, let's start off not with any images, we'll get to those in a minute. Let's start with a blank canvas. File and new, and from the presets here let's choose one of the photo 8x10, that'll do perfectly. So we have a blank canvas, but for this technique to work we really need it to be black and not white. So down to the keyboard, Control I on a PC, Command I on a Mac, and that'll invert the white to black. Okay, so we've got to burn something. What are we going to burn? Well, we're going to burn some text. Why not? So let's get the text tool, and we can choose a few different options up here. I've got the type of text, the font, set to Impact, which is a nice big, bold, brilliant font for this technique. The size, well, the size is kind of important. 72, well, that's just never going to be big enough, so let's make it 300. I don't know if that's the right size, but it's a good big size, and we can always change it later. Now, the colour of the font's going to be important. Black, well, black font, black background, that's not going to work, is it really? That's a disaster waiting to happen. So let's change the black to something a little warmer, a little more fiery. Let's try and find something a bit more sort of orangey red colour. Yeah, that looks good. Now, finally, along the end of the options bar here, we have the character and paragraph panel. Click that, and I'm going to change the tracking, which is a little AV thing with a left-right arrow. I'm going to change it to minus 50. What the tracking does is to tighten up the gap between the individual letters, so the whole font will have a much more compact look. Right, let's start typing, and we'll type something in here, like that. Now, as I said, 300 was a bit of a guess. In fact, it was slightly too big, so we'll use Free Transform, that's Control T, Command T on a Mac, and we'll just shrink it down and move it across and down to the position we want it, so hopefully round about there. Right, so we've got an orange font, black background. Ooh, exciting stuff. Well, stick with me, it'll get better, I promise. So what we're going to do now is to apply a couple of layer styles to try and give this the look of something that's been slightly more burnt. So let's double click on the layer, and on the layer style I'm going to bring up the gradient overlay option. Now there's a load of gradients you can choose, and I've got loads installed here, but really the only one we want to look at just at the moment is the black and the white one. Now, I've lost that nice kind of orangey burnt colour, but I'm going to get that back by changing the blend mode from normal to screen. Now, screen has a magic property. Anything pure black becomes completely transparent. So, hey presto, we can now see the orange coming back through the bottom. It's a little bit kind of too spread out for me, so I'm going to get the scale and just shrink this in a little bit, move it to the left. Not too far, otherwise it gets a little bit hard on the edge, but, you know, I like a less obvious blend than that. Okay, so that's pretty good. But whilst we're here, let's jump over to Bevel and Emboss, and we'll give our text a little bit more of a 3D feel. Bump up the size and maybe a little bit on the depth, and perhaps we'll soften it. And maybe let's move the angle as well, and let's see if that helps the look. That's pretty good. Maybe a little bit bright, so I'm going to take the opacity of the highlights down just to blend the whole thing in. A little bit like that. There we go. Great. Okay, so we now have given our text a brilliant-looking paint job. But we've got to burn our paint. We've got to get this looking like it's all burnt and a little bit cracked and a little bit damaged. Now, to do that, I'm going to apply a texture. Now, I've got a whole bunch of textures, but this is the one I want to use because this is a texture of cracking paint. So we'll get our Move tool. We'll drag that texture over and onto our main image and drop it on like that. Now, of course, I can't see the text anymore. The font has vanished because when I drag and drop, I end up with a new layer with our image over the top. So to blend those together, we're going to change the normal blend mode to multiply like that. Now, you can see straight away what it's done. That's really done a good job. It's given the whole text a nice kind of cracked look. That looks pretty good, actually. I can move it around, of course, because there's a whole bunch of other bits of image that I can't see. Can't go too far, I'll run out of texture. But I could have the cracking anywhere I want it. And I'm actually thinking pretty much back where I started was probably the right place. Yeah, round about there. Now, I don't want my whole text to have this effect, because I want it to look like it's burnt down a little bit here and there's still maybe some of the original paint job on the text down the bottom. So I'm going to apply a layer mask. And with a paintbrush set to black, let's get it a wee bit bigger. And we'll just put a few little black blobs in here, which will mask off the texture and reveal the original kind of text effect underneath. That's pretty good. I like it. Perhaps just down in the corners a little bit. Yeah, that's it. There we go. That's good. So what are we going to do now? Well, looking at the top of our text, if this was really on fire, this would be all singed and dark. So jumping back to the image itself, not the layer mask, that's an easy mistake to make, and working with black as our foreground colour, and working with a much smaller paintbrush again, I'm just going to darken these top bits down. I'm literally painting directly onto the texture, like that. And that's just going to hide it in. It's going to blend it in with our black background. Now you can see why that black background was so important. There we go. We'll just go in there, like that, and yeah, just try and take off any hard edges. Just give it a sort of singed edge. But also, if this was burnt as well, it wouldn't just be the top edge. It would also be a little darker, blended in, so you have a sort of gradient effect going down there. We can do that as well. Let's make a bigger brush, like that, and we'll just catch it just with the edge of that big brush, just so it darkens the whole thing in, like so. Right, okay, so that's looking pretty good. Our text is more or less complete. Now what we need to do is to put the flames on. This is the exciting bit. So let's jump over to the flame image. Here it is. We'll get the move tool and we'll do the same as we did before. We'll drag those flames over and onto our main picture, like so. And there we are. We now have a whole bunch of flames completely covering the picture. Now it's actually going to be way too big. So a bit of free transform, Control and T, Command T on a Mac. Nice little trick here for you. Control and zero, or Command zero, will zoom out so you can actually see the corner handles. That's such a useful thing to learn. I can't tell you how many times I've had to use that. There we go. We'll click the tick. Control zero, zoom us back in again. Good stuff. Okay, so there we have our flames about the right size, but we still can't see our image below. It's still there. So once again, we're going to change the blend mode from normal, and again we're going to use the screen because this will work the same way as it did with the text. Anything pure black, like the background here, will become transparent, and straight away you can see that this works a treat. That really does do the job. Now I can move those flames around. I can move them up and I can move them down and get them roughly where I want them to go. And you know, I'm actually thinking probably it wasn't a million miles adrift from where I wanted it in the first place. Maybe just down a little bit. We'll just nudge it down, and that's looking pretty good. Not completely happy with it. There's a few things I want to change. Let's have a look at the individual letters, because you can see there's bits of flames coming on to the whole of the text here. And down here where the original paint job is still intact, I don't think there should be any flames. So let's put a layer mask on there, and we'll get a paintbrush. We'll get a much smaller one than that, and we'll just paint away anywhere where the flames have gone where they shouldn't have done. So we'll just cover those bits up like that, and maybe a wee bit there, just like that. And not so keen on that one. I don't mind the other one. That seems like it's licking around the edge. Like that. That looks good. All adds to the three-dimensional look of the picture. Just spending a wee bit of time, little bit of time, just getting this looking as neat as possible. Not keen on that one either. Lovely. Okay, so the text is looking good. The flames are looking good. There's only one bit of flame I want to sort out, and it's down on the end here, because the end of the end doesn't have any flames on it at all. I could stretch it out, but then I'd lose the edge of that tip of flame there. So instead what I'm going to do is to get the clone tool, and really important bit, and I'm going to forget this if not, make sure I'm working on the actual image and not the layer mask. Happens too often, that one, but never mind. Yeah, right one this time. We'll click on an bit of flame there, and we'll just clone a bit of flame in, just like that. And maybe we'll find some kind of darker flames just to blend it in around about here somewhere. Lovely. Okay, so there we go. So this is all now on fire, and every bit of the text now has its own little flame licking up from underneath it. Okay, so there you go. There's how you can take just a bit of text, a couple of photographs, and create your very own flaming text effect.